Hey, cinephile, this one's for you. Your love of film allows us to do what we do. If you want to support us, the best way to do so is to hit that subscribe button. From Spotify to Apple to our video versions on YouTube, subscribing matters. Feel really compelled? Well, we want to hear from you. Have a burning question? An indie filmmaker we need to interview or a film we need to know about? Think you can make us laugh on the air? Drop us a comment or a review.
Hey everyone, welcome. It's the Fandor Video Podcast. I'm Hooman, my amazing co-host Chris Kelly.
Hey Hoo.
How are you today?
All right, doing
great.
Well.
Very well.
And?
So great to be alive.
Brilliant. Yeah. Woo! All right, we have a very special guest today. Her name is Sunnie McFadden. Is that correct, Sunnie?
Actually, Sunnie McFadden-Curtis.
Oh.
Sunnie McFadden is my acting name.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay.
Excellent.
And Sunnie, first of all, tell us about yourself and then tell us about your film, Broken Vows.
Well, before I stepped behind the camera, I was in front of the camera and I was acting. And then I took a hiatus from acting and stepped behind the camera. And let's see, I am a mother of two, and I am a fierce, loving mother. I love the beach and I love to dance, but no, I took a break. And so concurrently, I am acting and filmmaking at the same time.
Wow. How did the movie Broken Vows come to be?
Well, it came to be because I kept meeting an influx of women who were in this paralysis state or sequestered in the court system for far too long. And didn't know how to move on with their lives or couldn't move on with their lives because of being sequestered in the court system, et cetera. And they had questions and they had nowhere to turn to get the answers. And being an advocate for women and children, I took their questions and then some, and I set out to try and get those answers. And of course, that's what led me to Broken Vows, Stories of Separation.
I see now. You know, watching this movie, it seemed like the movie was therapy for them. And can I ask, therapy for you making this film? Was it did you do this movie to make a good documentary and also for like the therapeutic benefits you were getting as a result of making it?
Well, as I mentioned, I'm an advocate for women and children. So first and foremost, that was the forefront of my thought to make this documentary. But in terms of being therapeutic for me, I was so enthralled in this project and for a very long time that it really wasn't about me. It was more about my subjects. It was about whom I was going to help and could help. And so I haven't crossed that bridge yet. The dust is just starting to settle now. So perhaps I will cross that bridge and answer that question for myself.
Yeah. So how many women are portrayed? Is it like 10, would you say? 8, 10?
Good guess. It's six. Including me, it's 7.
Okay.
Six stories are more of the forefront. And then I have individuals, i.e. adult children of separation, family members, friends, who were caught in the crossfire, as well as experts, fabulous judge and lawyers, and the list goes on.
And so as you're talking to these people about divorce and separation and isolation and suffering and difficulty, what are like some of the good stories that came from this film, like either from the viewers or from the cast, where they came out at the end or they watched it and they said, Sunnie, this transformed me. Sunnie, I can't begin to tell you how much better I feel. Could you share some of those stories with us?
Sure. Okay. So if I may correct you, it's not about divorce. It's specifically about separation. Separation is that gray area that nobody really ever spoke about. And so there are plenty of documentaries on divorce, but this might be one of very few about separation. And some of the good stories are, well, a couple of my subjects at one of the small screenings I had for my cast mentioned that, and in fact, I saw this with my own eyes, them releasing what they've been holding on to, whether it be trauma and so on and so forth. I watched them release that because I had interviewed them multiple times. And so they were kind enough to share that this project help them release whatever trauma they might have been holding on to. And one of my subjects had mentioned that she thought she was over it. And then she went into this project and realized that she was still holding on to things and was able to also release that. But another story was, as I mentioned, I interviewed family members, and one of the fathers of one of my subjects, and because I wanted to get his perspective as a parent, had been holding on to something for 36 years that he shared with nobody except me, as he's sitting across from me, I'm interviewing him. And I watched him as well release as he teared up and shared his story. And then he was able to move forward after that. And then one of my crew members, who is actually DP, who is a crew member, but he's my director of photography. He's fairly young when he started the project, and he feels he knows now what to take into relationships and what to try and avoid. And so those were some of the great stories that came out of it.
Oh, that's great. So, you know, you interviewed six people, but there are so many other stories. There's hundreds, thousands. Do you see this turning into a series? Do you want to keep pursuing this topic?
Well, it's funny you should ask, because as you know, viewing the documentary, 50% of marriages end in separation. So there's a lot of stories out there, unfortunately, and stories that need to be heard. So in answer to your question, I may have a couple of things in development in terms of
this. There we go. Yep.
Okay. So how about if we could talk about you personally, are you, I'm assuming you're separated. Are you dating? Are you done with dating? Are you on Tinder? Are you pro-marriage? Are you anti-marriage? Where do you stand in all
that? Whoa. What's coming at me here? no. I might have been on the sites at one point or another. But I am talking to some people. In terms of being pro-marriage or anti-marriage, every marriage to me is a case-by-case situation. I would never paint every marriage with the same brush. So if, you know, I may have gone into a relationship that was wrong for me, far be it from me to make a choice that that's the end for me in terms of marriage. So if it's with the right person, of course I'm pro-marriage.
Oh, that's great. Okay, so what's next for you? I mean, you hinted that there might be a series here.
The series option is, I think, a fascinating one, right?
You think she should pursue that, Chris?
Well, I mean, look, I obviously want her to comment on that as opposed to my opinion.
No, Chris, I think I want to hear your answer.
Yeah, we all do, Chris. What do you think she should do now? Do you think she should get in front of the camera again? Should she start acting?
I think she said that she's continued acting.
I am, in fact. I have a film coming out, just a small role, because I'm just getting back into it, on Netflix, called Code 8. But anyway, in terms of what I'm working on, well, I mentioned that I have, you know, well, I actually have multiple projects in various stages of development. But I mentioned I have a couple in terms of that topic, but I'm also presently working in early stages on a psychological thriller. Mm. So I'm thinking about stepping away from documentary for a moment, and also a heartfelt drama.
Okay. Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Do you want to tell us about this psychological thriller? What can you say? Like, is it you and like Keanu Reeves and Johnny Depp, or?
Well, I'll tell you who I'd love to play the lead in either of these films. And I heard you, and that might be interesting.
Uh-huh.
What you mentioned. So I would love to see Halle Berry play either one of these roles for my up and coming films.
Okay.
I can say that. And I can say that the women leads in this project are heroes.
Mm. Okay. Great. All right. Oh, yeah.
Sorry, go ahead.
No, you go ahead. Anything else you want to say about it?
Well, how about I come back when I'm further along in the process and share more with you?
Well, we always want to end with movies that have like really impacted you, that have made you love film, movies that inspire you. So can you give us like three or four movies that made a difference in your life?
Okay. Three movies that have impacted my life. Okay. You're probably not going to guess. You probably couldn't guess what I'm going to say, but I'll start with Dr. Zhivago.
Okay.
Why Dr. Zhivago? Well, I'm a hopeless romantic, number one. And number two, it's one of the last cinematic films to date and shot beautifully. Number two would be Rear Window. Oh. Why? Because simple can be captivating.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Sorry.
Are you a big Hitchcock fan?
I am.
Did you ever see Rebecca?
No.
Okay, so that's his only film that won Best Picture. It's 1940. It's Laurence Olivier.
You should check it out. It's exceptional.
Way before my time, but I absolutely will mark that down.
Listen, don't watch the remake. The remake's terrible.
It is.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Just watch the original.
We tried.
Who starred in the remake?
Armie Hammer, I think. Yeah.
Oh. So it's really recent.
Yeah, it's no good. It's no good. But okay, watch Laurence Olivier, you know, he could very well be, you know, in the top three actors who ever lived. So
of course. okay, so and my final film.
Yes, here we go.
Broken Vows, Stories of Separation. Have you heard of it?
Oh wow. Well, yeah.
Have you heard of it?
Not only have I heard of it, I watched
changing
it.
Your life.
Okay, so I'll tell you why. Because when I see that film, it represents to me the strength that I have. And B, it represents the people I've helped and the people it's going to continue helping.
Yes.
So for that, I'm very proud of it. And I love it.
Oh. As you should be. So,
yeah.
Rear Window is one of my favorite films.
Really?
And yeah, absolutely. And the musing on themes of you know, how what you see through different windows, and understanding, you know, I've done a lot of work in privacy over the course of my career, and areas where you know, what's seen and what's not is a critical part of that, and Rear Window just captures those themes extraordinarily well in an entertaining and challenging format.
Completely. And I mean, sometimes, as you all know, less can be so much more.
No, it's a very simple
left to the imagination.
Exactly. And the acting is just sublime. I mean,
isn't it?
The Jimmy Stewart and Grace Kelly are just absolutely perfect.
Stellar performances.
Yeah.
Well, Sunny, your film is Broken Vows. It's on.
Sorry to interrupt you.
Here we go.
Broken Vows, Stories of Separation.
Stories of Separation.
Broken Vows, Stories of Separation. Forgive me. Fandor. It's on Fandor now. And Sunny, if people want to get in touch with you, is there a way?
Absolutely. I believe that it's going to be on Fandor, if I stand corrected, on the 19th of April. But if it's on now, that's even better.
No. This is going to air on the 19th.
Got it.
Leave all that in.
You tricked me. Okay. where they can get me on Instagram, it's Sunny, S-U, Norman, I-E, or N-N-I-E, Biz, B-I-Z, 13. And Broken Vows documentary on Instagram as well. And or my website is brokenvowsfilm.com.
Wow. All right. Well, Sunny, such a pleasure to meet you, and
Likewise. Obviously
we wish you nothing but the best. And if you're ever in the Bay Area, let us know. You know, we'd love to meet you face to face.
I may hold you to that.
You should. Thanks so much.
All right, Sunny. Thanks so much.
Thank you so much.
Take care.
Take care.
Good night, guys.